Hey, bad buddies. Paul Roberts, RT1 here. A little finishing up the business at the end of the year here. I want to show you a little bit more about molding since I went ahead and showed you how to mold. I want to show you how you can work on a mold you already have and do it cheaper just by knowing what to do and working with what you already have. I'm letting these go. They weren't claimed. I'm giving it to the second place winner. I wanted to have this long, drawn-out thing about what was it, but we didn't do that because he got it right away. What's on the table today? Just the basic stuff, but I wanted to go over this with you because I thought I might be able to show you something and help you to understand what you can do if you're molding. This is a mummy sword. For some reason, I got a couple of orders recently. I don't know why. I usually maybe get one a year. I said to myself, you know what? This was deteriorating, and I wanted to go ahead and use some of the silicone I had and just do the crucial parts. Not the whole thing, but the crucial parts. So let me show you how I do that.
So I think you know enough about molding now, based on the last video where I showed you basic concepts of molding for this bat belt buckle, that I could just tell you what I did here, and maybe you can get it and understand the importance of it. This is an old mummy sword. It was from a hero prop from the movie. It's battle damaged, it's not perfect, but I really looked for like a decade to get my hands on this. And so I went ahead and made a mold for resin, even though the real one is foam with steel inside. And I didn't want to spend a lot of money on redoing this important part, but after about a decade, it needed to be redone. For some reason, this silicone, this purple silicone, I forget what it's called, wore out way faster and became much more brittle than any other silicone I've ever worked with. I don't know why I used this at the time. It's too long ago. I can't remember. But what I did was I cut it out and I saved this little portion and this little portion and this little portion and this little portion. And I cut it out so it goes past the handle. So if I have to do any detail work, it'll just be this little area here where it joins, but it looks like it came out pretty good. We'll see how that works on the first casting. And what I did was I just poured up both sides one at a time of just this section and just this section. Now, if I wanted to do this whole thing, it would have required like three of these. I don't want to spend that kind of money. I mean, I was kind of surprised that I got more than two orders this year. Usually I get like one a year. And I thought, well, do I want to keep on struggling with this old stuff, or do I want to use it while it's still there and recreate it? So what I did was I put all these registration marks so that this would always line up perfectly with this when they're joined together and put inside this frame. I'm just showing you that if you wanted to do something, if you already have something, you can do this. If you already have something to work with. I made this all solid like this. I didn't have to. I could have got a little closer, but I really felt the size of this needed this. But I'll do like a gun mold or something like that. And if I want to save myself some money, I'll put like this in there. And I won't do a whole square. This will just be a space holder to keep. It's like a dam wall again, right? Or a blessed wall again, like we talked about before. This will keep the silicone, which is much more expensive, in place. And instead of a square mold, you get something like that. That's a way to save some cost. Just wanted to point this out for what it's worth. So that's the video for today. And just to tack on the end here, the winner was, well, it was somebody else, but then he withdrew it. I'm not sure why. Maybe he just wanted to give it to somebody else. But the winner was Patch. He's fast. So this is going out. He's asked me to talk about my perfect suit, and I'm going to do that. But one of the things I wanted to say, just from old business, the treasure video trailer, I'm moving that over to Conscious Counseling. It's going to get way too long, and I don't want to put it here at this time. It's not something you'd be interested in anyway. But that's what's happening to that. So I just want to talk for a few minutes, tagging on the end of this, instead of typing a reply just to one bat buddy, just talk about my perfect suit. My perfect bat suit, even though whenever I've gone out, I just grab whatever I can, put something together, and I just go out and have fun in costume. I haven't done that for a while since my best friend and a person I call Alfred's gotten heavy and he hasn't been wanting to go across the trade show floors with me for about 8 years now. So I really haven't been costuming. I've been helping others to do it for a while because I really want to do it with my bat buddies. And sometimes that's hard, especially this year. There's nothing going on at all. But talking about my perfect suit for nostalgia reasons and other reasons, which I'll explain now, is the Adam West suit. Why? Well, Super Friends also, you know, that look. Why is that my ideal suit? All these other really cool suits that we have today are about battling more hostile foes. Bullets, mega fights. Adam West just jumped out into action
with just his wits about him, and the most he was going to have was a fist fight or a trap.
I would rather live in a world that was simple enough to be where all I needed to confront was ideas, or someone that every once in a while gets a little bit off and needs a correction. I would rather not exemplify how glamorous it is to go into battle and pummel our enemies and shoot at them or bop them with our batarang as we get shot at. I know that's the way our world is today, but I choose to react to that world by extending a hand, a philosophy, a conscious counseling. Consider this other way. It may not work. We may be killed. We may lose the battle. But I would rather lose the battle extending a hand of peace and friendship to anybody than to do what Batman does. As far as I'm concerned, what Batman does is vengeance, and just as bad as one little kid slapping another because he slept. I believe in turning the other cheek, if at all possible, and not elevating the situation of our world. And so my perfect bat suit would be frozen in time, where all he did was go after these fantastic villains that just had a couple of things wrong. And every once in a while in the Catwoman one, I mean, she's obviously really attractive, but I like the Catwoman ones. Why? Because he tried to reach out to her and tried to get her to see that there was another way. And his heart went out to her. To my way of thinking, I know that sounds like so much mush. And who would want that Batman to be the cool Batman? It just isn't, right? But to me it is. Because in his heart, I think he felt that there was possible for redemption. I think he felt that it was possible to sway somebody over to another way of thinking. Look, he has this youthful ward. He brings them up in the proper way. Tries to make up for the fact that he didn't have parents. The youthful ward lost his parents. Tries to make up for the fact even in his daily dealings. And so I look at the humanitarian cause of Batman higher than the vengeful, fighting, triumphant, super cool Batman. And that's why that would be my dream suit. So that's the video for today, folks. That's the way I view it. And I like all the coolness, I like all the fantasy, I like all the other stuff, don't get me wrong. But I live for what I live for. What's behind the mask. And those thoughts and ideals are what I stand for in real life. With my family, friends, those that know me. Everything I try to do. So that's my thoughts for today. I put it at the end of the video because most people don't want to hear that. That's it, Bat Buddies. Talk to you later. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1.